braced here. So in this video, we're going to draw a rectangle. And in doing so, we will be learning about the perpendicular and the parallel line tools. And again, just like in the previous videos, we will not be needing the graphics or the coordinate axes and the algebra view. So we will just be using the geometry perspective. So we select the geometry perspective from the perspective window. Next, the first thing that we are going to do is to draw our first side, which is segment AB. Okay, so this is the first side of the rectangle. Next, we want to draw lines which are parallel to AB and passing through A, and at the same time passing through B. The other one is passing through A, and the other one is passing through B. So to do that, we use the perpendicular line tool, and then we select the point and the perpendicular line from the instruction here. But I do the reverse. I select first the line. Select first the line and then the point. Okay, so I can see the line. Next, select the line and then the point. So that's the first side. And these two lines will contain the sides of my rectangle. Next, I draw the third vertex on this line. Okay, so as you can see, if you draw a point on a line, so even if I drag it outside, the point remains on that line. Okay, so that's the difference between the independent and semi-independent objects. So some objects are independent, like A and B. I can drag it anywhere. I can drag them anywhere. While C, you can only drag it on this line, so you can drag it outside. Okay, so that's my first vertex, or my third vertex. And then I'll use the parallel line tool to draw a line which is parallel to AB and passing through C. Next, I draw the fourth vertex using the intersect tool. So I'll intersect these two lines so I can have my fourth vertex here. So this one, I click on this one and then on this line. So these are my four vertices. Of course, I can move them, except B, of course, because D is dependent on the line, this line, and this line, so I can move D. Okay. So D is a fixed object. A and B are independent objects. C is a semi-dependent object. And D is a fixed object. Next, I don't really need these lines, so I'll hide them. Right-click on each of them and then select show objects, and then I'll use the segment tool to connect the points. Okay. So again, how do we show the lines that we have hidden? We go to the algebra view using this menu here at the top right, and then go to view and then select algebra view. So the hidden objects here are the objects with white circles. So if you click on them, they will show the hidden objects. Alright, so that's it for this. Oh, before I end, how do we rename the objects? For example, I want to rename this rectangle to PQRS. So I'll just right-click on the point. Click on rename P and then Q, and then R, and S. I'm sorry about the fan. It's a laptop's fan. Okay, so that's it for this tutorial. I hope you enjoyed it. Don't forget to invite your friends. We will have more tutorials in the days to come. See you!